Good morning everyone, and for today I'm going to do a quick get ready with me video. I already have my cleanser, my morning skincare routine, so it's cleanser. I just added brightening because I had a few marks recently popped up, so I added brightening after that, and climate control and daytime. So those are the first things I did, and then I just added silk because I'm going to do a CCTM now. So silk is our pore and wrinkle minimizer. It's our primer, so I always add it as part of my skincare routine because it needs like 10-15 minutes to sit on your skin to work better. And also even if you don't want to do a foundation, you can still do silk as part of your skincare because it has aloe, so it's always good for people who has acne, and it's non-comedogenic, so it will not break out your skin. And also it's going to start helping you to reduce pore and pores, so that is a very good thing to add to your list. So let me go ahead and do CCTM first. I always do just a CCTM, but if you need a little bit more coverage, you can add our concealer in your shade. So mine is a medium concealer. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take like a full pump of medium to deep CCTM. That's my shade. So we carry six different shades, so it's easy to color match. So then I'm going to take like a tiny bit of the concealer. So I'm going to take just this much. I know this is little lot, but I squeezed it, so I'm going to anyway use them. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to mix it even just with my back of my brush. What this does is this makes the consistency even more thick, and the coverage will be like medium to full coverage. Because usually CCTM is a sheer coverage, but I know many of you like a medium coverage. I am okay with sheer coverage because I feel like I don't have to hide anything, so I am always okay with it. But if you prefer, you need a little more coverage, so make sure you add concealer to it. So I'm going to use my brush. What I'm going to do is I'm going to stipple. The difference between stippling and wiping down is you take a bit of the foundation and you just press it down your skin. So instead of doing a wiping motion, when you stipple, you press these foundations in your skin. So CCTM is going to color correct your redness, and also it has SPF 15 equivalent of a mechanical shield, so it's going to act as part of your sunscreen too. And since I already have daytime moisturizer which has another SPF 15, I have a coverage of SPF 30 in it. So you can see how much it has color matched, but you can see the unevenness in the side of the skin, whereas this side it has corrected that. And this is so lightweight and all day wear, so it's not going to clog your pores or make you break out, so it's perfect for everyday wear. So I'm going to finish on this side too. And if you're not doing any eyeshadow, you can actually use this on your eyelids too and just color correct for an everyday look. Always make sure you do your neck, that way it seamlessly blends well. Our CCTM is so lightweight, and none of our foundations are like a heavy or oily. They all adapt to your skin tone and blend so well, and they all go as liquid foundation, but they all are cream to powder. So once they set, they look like a semi matte. If you want like a complete matte, you can use a translucent powder and do like a coat on top of it. So I think that I look when I was doing desert rose, I was keep on saying that I wanted this to be done as separately. So that is the color I'm going to do for my eyes today. So first let me color correct using natural tan. As I said, if you're doing like a everyday look where just for office or like going out, you can skip this step and use the CCTM itself on your eyes and color correct, because when you color correct, what it does is it gives you a clean canvas for you to work with the color that goes on top. So you can either do the CCTM itself, or you can, our Shadow Sense doesn't need any primer, so instead of that you just color correct with the shade you want. We do carry like candlelight, which is even lighter than that. I like a natural tan for my everyday looks, so that's the color I have used for today. So our Shadow Sense is again cream to powder, so you will always start with a small layer and then build it up. I'm going to use a fluffy brush and take the product from here, because with Shadow Sense it's easy to build the color rather than using it all at once. So this way you can easily stop where you want to. So if you go with too much product, then blending will also be difficult for you, and it will be patchy. So always make sure you start with a really really small amount of product, and when you are going for like everyday look, you are not going to do like too many bright shades, or you're not going to do it too dark. So when you do like very light layers, they blend so well and they make for a perfect everyday look to office or as I said, even for a grocery trip. Desert Rose is a semi matte. When the day I tried it as a complete look, I tried it with the sun-baked shimmer. So this is more of a, what is it, like a semi matte, so it has like a pearly finish rather than a shimmery finish. So always make sure to run the color underneath your eyes. You can see the difference between an eye that is with the Shadow Sense color and without, because these colors give you a nice finished look, but at the same time it's not going to take a lot of time. So let me go ahead and finish the other side too and then show you. So I did finish both sides. As I said, since it's an everyday look, I'm not going to add more colors to it. But if you're doing for a special occasion, you can always add a darker shade in the corner, or you can even add like a shimmer to the inner corner to make your eyes pop. So those are like some of the suggestions you can do. I'm going to do our brown pencil for today. So I'm going to use it just under the waterline. Again, like Shadow Sense and Lip Sense and foundation, our eye pencils are the liquid eyeliners. All of them are all day wear and smudge proof. So they aren't going to go anyway unless you remove it at the end. If you think your eye are a little watery, or you have like oils in them, then oily lids, you can always use like a Q-tip before you run your pencils there. That will help the to absorb any water that before it goes on. That makes it stay longer. So I'm going to use the non-waterproof mascara for my today's look. So you can always add our Lash Sense primer if you think your eyelashes are little brittle and they need to be conditioned, because what it does is when you do a Lash Sense primer, it is going to help and condition the lashes, because our mascara is not only all day wear, but they also have an ingredient called Capixel, which is going to help the lashes to grow in a period of 4 weeks, and you can go up to 3 coats of our mascara, and as I said, they won't feel like too stiff, and it's really easy to remove at the end of the day. And we do have waterproof one if you have if you think your eyelids will water more. So for special occasions and the day you need a longer time, obviously go for the waterproof. The non-waterproof is still water resistant, so if you are not going to smudge it, then you can still use it. So for me, I use the non-waterproof one for like everyday looks, and I use waterproof for special days. Whenever I do an eye look, I always say, like, until you do your mascara and eyeliner, you never judge an eye look, because unless you do them, it's never complete. And when you do, always make sure you do top and bottom, because that really helps for it. Because if you do only the bottom, then you won't get the length. So always make sure you do both sides. So for, since being an everyday look, I had picked few color choices for you to see. You can do girlfriend, which is a nice matte shade. You can do blush. Kiss for a Sauce is always a favorite combo. If you need a little darker one, Crystal Mauve will be a good choice too. These three are sheer coverage. What does it means is it is going to be really, really light, and you can build the color up to 4 layers. And obviously the new Boysenberry is there if you need even more pop of color. So I am thinking I will do Boysenberry for this look. But these are other choices if you think this is little bold or a darker shade. But these will go really, really beautifully, and all of them are matte shades for your everyday look. So let me clean my lips, and that's the first step when you do lip sense. So always make sure you clean your lips. Since we have applied the shadow sense and foundations and all, always make sure you clean your lips well. That way you don't have any of the particles. You can see, do you see? We think that there is nothing, but we always end up having a little bit of it. What this does is it's going to prevent the lip sense from staying longer, because lip sense wants to molecularly bond with your lips. So when you have any other particles, it's going to prevent from staying and it starts breaking out. So make sure to clean it. And the next step will be always shake the color well and do 3 thin coats. And for the gloss, the similar way, I had 3 choices. Like you can go with the Madeline or metallic rose. Madeline will be a matte color, metallic rose will be like a pearly shine, or if you want a glittery shade, you can go with pink prism. I think I am going with the Boysenberry with the either matte gloss or the Madeline. So let me go ahead and do 3 layers of Boysenberry and seal it and come back and show you. So I did finish Boysenberry with Madeline gloss. So if you're a glossy lover, you can pretty much pick any of these. And if you are thinking like if you wanted to go matte, you can always wear matte glosses. Like for me, I am a glossy person, so any of these glossy shades, I really like it. So since Boysenberry is like a very pigmented gloss, you can even do 1 or 2 layers of it, and you can even top it with the matte gloss. Or if you need a little bit of shimmer, you can add a color like a pink prism will add a nice shimmer to the color. So let's go over the products that I have used for today's look. So for the face, I have used CCTM in the shade medium to deep, and I mixed it with the medium concealer for more coverage. And I have used Desert Rose for my eye color. That's the color I have used. I have used the brown pencil and the Lash Sense non-waterproof mascara. And for the lips, I have used Boysenberry with Madeline gloss. So it's a really, really quick look. So if you if it's not like a video where I do, it's hardly going to take like less than 5 minutes to complete the entire look. I always say you can start with even one layer of lipsticks and parallelly do your foundation, so it is like you will finish them like all together instead of waiting for one at a time. Since I'm explaining, I do each one separately, but if you are like doing for a everyday look, you can do them together. And tomorrow, even though it's Friday, since it's a long weekend, I will not be posting my sari post for this week. We are going to paint the house, so I'm going to take off and spend some family time, and also I'll be still posting the pictures but not the sari post anyway. So you all enjoy the long weekend. Happy 4th of July too, and see you all soon in the new content.